Existence socialization refers to the idea of the dog or puppy being able to be around different dogs, animals, people in different environments without feeling the need to react. There's a million different reasons why a dog or puppy might learn to become reactive as they grow. And not all of those are necessarily negative things. Sometimes, because of that definition of socialization that's publicly known, which is to allow the dog to interact with everything, because of that, a lot of times what happens is that the dog gets into the mindset that anyone who's passing by, anyone who's coming close, anyone who looks at them is there to greet them, is there to interact with them. So the dog may start to feel excited immediately upon getting that eye contact. Another common reason a lot of dogs may become reactive is because people have a tendency of not respecting their boundaries. This is especially common when it comes to small dogs, but it's also common when it comes to your family breeds, such as your golden retrievers or your labs, the dogs that everyone loves to interact with. They see them as the iconic family dog. One way I'll combat that is through existence socialization exercises. I'll go to a different place, like a gas station, or like in this video, a pet store or something of that sort, and I'm going to have them lay down and relax. And that's it. Maybe I might do some basic obedience with them if they're getting a little bit too focused on the people or animals or whatever's going around. But my main goal is to just teach them to sit there and relax. This is going to show the dog that other people, other animals, other dogs, cats, whatever's going around, this is going to show them that thing, even though it's nearby, doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to come to you. And again, that becomes the key root of a lot of these reactivity issues, is the idea that for good or ill, the dog expects the person or the other dogs or animals to notice it and then interact with it. Because that's what we're taught to do through traditional socialization. And so, again, whether it's good or bad, the dog is learning that if someone's around, they need to interact with it. In the beginning process, when we're first introducing this idea to the dog, what we're going to want to find is the dog's threshold. And what that means is how far away the dog can be from the stimulus before they decide to react. Dogs explore the world primarily through their nose, so even if they're not looking at the person, they are well aware that the person is there. So we want to find that point, and then we're going to stop there. We're going to do some basic obedience, we're going to sit down and relax, we're going to simply ignore the distractions. If the dog gets a little bit too focused on those distractions, then we're going to stand up, maybe turn around or something of that sort, and practice some basic obedience. We're going to teach the dog that when there's stimulus going on, their focus should be on me. So that means when I do these exercises, I always make sure to bring, in the beginning, high value rewards, be it cheese or hot dogs or something of that sort, something that's amazing, so that they learn that I'm more interesting than anything that's going on in the environment. If you're not doing basic obedience routines during this process, that's okay. Just be sure to treat the dog often and treat them at the right time. And one thing that I look for is eye contact. So if my dog is noticing someone else or another dog in this scenario, I'm going to do something to get their focus on me, and then I'm gonna pop a treat in their mouth. And that's because, again, I want the dog to find me more interesting than the rest of the environment. Once the dog starts to get comfortable at their threshold, and that may take hours, that may take days, that may take weeks, it all depends on the dog, and you and how often you practice this. But once the dog starts to become comfortable at their threshold, that's when we can, similarly to the techniques that we used in stay, but kind of the opposite, that's when we can start moving a step closer. And once they get comfortable at that threshold, then we can move a step closer. And slowly but surely, we're trying to get closer and closer to that entrance, like you see in the video. If we are to the point of expanding our threshold of getting a little bit closer, but the dog starts to become more reactive towards the things around them, that's okay to take a couple steps backwards away from the stimulus and try again, start again. And that's one reason why I like to use locations like pet stores or gas stations or Walmart or something like that, because the actual stimulus, even though there's people moving around and all that stuff, the actual stimulus is stationary. It's staying still. It's not moving. So yeah, there's people coming in and out, but the fact that it's a store means that no matter how long I stay there, there will be people coming in and out with their dogs. This affords me the opportunity to, if I need to, again, remove myself and the dog from the stimulus, I can go back a few feet, but the entrance is staying there. And so I can actually control how quickly we move along this process. If the dog is getting too uncomfortable, it's okay, I can move back. And then we can slowly start weaning forward. So thanks for watching this video on existence socialization. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please leave them in the comments section below. As always, don't forget to smash that like button, don't forget to click that red subscribe button, and join me on this journey of some minor dog training where I teach you how to train yourself to better train your dogs.